Hey guys, Ian Higton from Platform32, back again with another Let's Play stroke first impressions. This time I'm going to be playing Forza Horizons, which is the newest game in the Forza series for the Xbox 360, which is developed by Playground Games and Turn 10 Studios, and it's published by Microsoft, because it's only out on the Xbox 360, yeah! So this is going to be released on the 23rd of October. This video is coming out just as the review embargoes lift, and I'm going to be showing you basically the first few bits of the game's single player campaign, and hopefully give you a quick tour of the multiplayer. No one's online with the multiplayer at the moment, so there's not much I can show you there except for the menus, etc. So if I load up the single player game and read a little bit of this press sheet that I've got given. Forza Horizon was developed by Playground Games in association with Turn 10 Studios. Playground Games brings a great deal of racing game experience to the Forza series, and the studio is comprised of some of the games industry's most creative development talent, including talented developers from respected racing studios such as Codemasters, Bizarre Creations, BlackRock Studios, and more. So lots and lots of good talent in the development team there. So I'm racing in the first car you start with, which is a really poopy Volkswagen. The controls and everything are very, very similar to Forza games. All the physics are the same, done on the same engine, I do believe. So anyone who's played a Forza game before is going to feel right at home. But what they've done here with Forza Horizon is they've tried to make it a little bit more accessible for players who aren't into super like specced out racing games. If I press the back button, it'll bring up the map. Now the big difference with Forza Horizon compared to the other Forza games is Forza Horizon is an open world game, so this huge map is it's based in Colorado, basically. This game, it's an open world racing game based in Colorado, and it's based around a fictitious festival called the Horizon Festival, which is the hub here. The Horizon Festival hub is where you you start off, you get all your missions, and you've got your garage there and a spray shop so you can spray your car and stuff. I've done one, the beginner race. The next race that you're given is this, which is a showcase race, where I've got to go there and I've got to race a Ford Mustang against a Mustang plane. And the appearance fee, I'll get 5,000 credits for winning, and for appearing, and if I win the race, I'll get to keep the car. So I'll take a drive up there, and while I'm driving, I'll try and read you some stuff about Forza Horizon. Let's go back and select that and exit map. Okay, so we're following this GPS. There is a woman voice for the GPS that'll tell you where to turn and stuff. I guess you can probably turn it off if you want. Turn her voice off. You can use Kinect to do the GPS as well in free roam in the multiplayer. I don't know if there's no options here yet for it, so who knows if it works in single player game while you're doing this kind of campaign mode. It's a kind of generic campaign mode. You start off with a crap car. You're some kind of like random racer. You start this tournament and basically racing your way to the top and unlocking cars as you go. It's A to handbrake, I think. Oh, fuck, I'm so bad at racing games. So if you've this is what Microsoft is saying about Forza physics and open world equals Forza Horizon. If you played a Forza Motorsport game before, you'll feel right at home. I'm reading while driving, which is why I'm driving so bad. You'll feel right at home in Forza Horizon. The same authentic physics that powered the Forza Motorsport series are in play here in Horizon. As a result, every car should feel like it has unique handling characteristics and capabilities, a personality all of its own. If you've never played a Forza game before, you'll be able to choose from a spectrum of driving assists and difficulty options to precisely dial in the experience you want to have. I've arrived at my destination. Sign me up by pressing X. Experts can turn on simulation steering and switch off the TCS and ABS, while beginners can turn all assists on and let the familiar Forza green line show them the best way to manage Colorado's trickier corners. It's up to you. All the cars in Horizons are designed to be authentic recreations of their real-life counterparts. Driving them in Horizon has a flair and feel of its own. Blah, 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 blah. So let's press X.
Showcase events are all about entertaining the crowd. But if you need an extra incentive, the sponsor will throw in the car if you win. Nice work if you can get it, huh?
Yes, it is. So let's enter the event. The Horizon Festival is the headquarters of Forza Horizon, by the way. It's home to the hottest summer music festival around. As you can see here on the right, you've got the lineup for the Horizon Festival. All these bands feature on the three radio stations that you can switch between in the cars. Some good bands there. Particular fan of dubstep at the moment. There's lots of good dubstep in this game, including Skrillex and Nero and stuff like that. So you can choose your difficulties if you want.
And then race to
what's
the
she saying?
Line.
Shut up, woman.
The plane has a much bigger turning circle than you, but in a straight line, it's faster. So this is going to be close.
Okay, so I'm racing against the plane. You can set the difficulties if you want. I'm going to keep it all on the default settings, basically. Quickly for the Horizon Festival, in the main hub bit you get an auto show where you can buy and sell cars from Forza Horizon's massive collection of car manufacturers. You get Dax Garage, where you can upgrade your cars. You can choose to automatically upgrade them or improve the individual parts yourself. Dax is also where you can switch between any of the cars in your collection and find cars that Dax has restored for you. I'll continue reading in a second because I think this plane is kicking my ass because I'm not paying attention. Yeah, place 2 out of 2. So, riding a Ford Mustang at the moment, which reminds me a bit like Dukes of Hazzard. What's this plane doing? How am I supposed to beat that plane? Is it doing like a million laps at once? I don't know. I'm still second. The graphics are really nice. They've got some kind of day and night cycle thing going on as well. Oh, I'm first now. That's not helping, driving into that. Yeah, there's a day and night cycle that goes on, so sometimes you'll be driving this in the daytime, sometimes you'll be driving it in the nighttime. Sometimes as you're driving, it'll turn from day to night really fast, like there's some kind of spooky solar eclipse going on. It's all very nice, though. Fuck you, that plane buzzed me like a bitch. When you're driving around doing races as well, you will have planes and stuff buzzing you and helicopters flying past. There's lots of stuff going on. They've really made an effort in creating a kind of like a believable, well, I don't say believable, like a busy world. Driving around, sometimes you'll get oncoming traffic in the other lanes. There's none in this track, but I guess showcase events would have closed off roads. The cars are all handling pretty nice, as you'd expect from a Forza game, although, you know, I don't drive in real life, so I can't tell if these are real or not. Took that corner alright. The plane's in first place though now. I'm driving too slow, I think. I need to start using my handbrake or something, maybe. This car is slippy as fuck. Come on, car. Stupid plane. Tunnels as well, eh? I'm hoping after I finish this event it doesn't make me do it again, because otherwise this Let's Play's going to be boring as fuck! First again, though. I don't really understand how this is judging who's winning and who's not. It's just some plane occasionally flies over my head and goes, fuck you, I'm in a plane! No. Oh, dick. There's probably a reset to track button, but if there is, I don't know what the hell it is. 95% progress. That plane better not overtake me now. Come on, win me. Yay. What? Fuck off. That was ridiculous. I swear I finished first. Unless it just instantly beat me right at the end. They gave me the car anyway because they're impressed with what I did, but still.
I knew it. You just bagged a sweet new ride, and now you know why showcase events are invite only. Everyone wants to get their hands on one of those.
Sweet. So, a new car anyway, so that's good. So also at the Horizon Festival, you get the paint shop, where you can customise the decals and the vinyl systems of your car and stuff. You can design your the storefront here, where you can search from a massive base of liveries and creations designed by the Forza community. In Forza, unless you've painted a car with a custom livery, it's not really yours. We're kidding, of course, but taking advantage of the livery editor in Forza Horizon really is one of the best ways to make your car your own. What did that woman just say? Please set a route to Race Central. Okay. Set a route to, Race Central and go there. Race Central is where you pick up new wristbands you've earned as you progress through Forza Horizon.
I showcase events like that Mustang race for the fans, and I try to book the most popular drivers. If you want to get invited, increase your popularity at the festival by showing off your skills as you drive. Maybe if you get more popular, I'll give you a call.
Ah, give me a call. That's right, baby. So, yeah. Shit. Read them again. yeah, you can access all your rival events from Race Central, including new monthly rival events added on a regular basis by the Forza community team. And there's also a car club in the race app where you can create or join a car club with and share thing cars in your garage with your friends and compete against them.
You lost that skill chain. You don't win fans driving like that.
Okay, so you can also, there's kind of like skill chains which act as combos. Meters,
turn left.
I lost it, like, driving like a knob end. 250th? Oh, shit! Oh. Oh, you can rewind by pressing Y. Which is good, I guess. I still didn't slow down in time to make that corner without driving like a bell. Come on, me! This car's very slippy. So yeah, I'm more of a first-person shooter than a driver, but this Let's Play's not to show off my driving skills. It's to show you race fans the kind of what you'll be seeing when you pick up the game on October the 23rd. Not August the 23rd, otherwise you'd have to go in a time machine and go into the past, or you'd already have the game, and this Let's Play would be irrelevant, or an elephant. I don't know what I'm talking about now. I'm just gibbering. Our rank 3 is unlocked. I've got 10,000 credit, plus a speed challenge of something. That's how you get round corners. You smash into other cars to slow yourself down. Here's the night cycle going into effect. Anyway, it's late evening. You can see the Forza Horizon Festival. Fuck! You can see the Forza Horizon Festival in the background there. That's where we're headed. With fireworks going off and the big lights in the sky. Those white dots on the mini-map on the radar down to the left must be other racers. I'm not sure whether you can challenge them or not by crashing into them or what. I'm pretty sure it's not like... I can't remember it now. That racing game that's set on Hawaii or whatever, where everyone is online races. I don't think it's like that. I don't think when you're playing solo campaign, everyone on here is different online people. Past the speed camera. The speed cameras, the speed traps, if you're in America. They capture speed. They record your best speed as you go through them. There we go. We're in the festival bit now. A couple of races up ahead of me. See what happens if I crash into them. Nothing. Except you might have got a bit angry. Fly flew in my face. Go away, fly. So I'll show you a quick look at the hub. Do another race of sorts, hopefully, and then I'll show you the multiplayer. So there's a marketplace where you can buy stuff. It's a big oval. Car club. Race Central. Hopefully it won't automatically put me in there. No, good. Auto show. All these things you can stop on. Wristband holders only. I think I get my wristband from the... Race Central in a second. Garage, paint shop. Should I have it? Wristband holders only. Alright, I'm just going to get a wristband. Here we go. Sounds a bit like Sigourney Weaver. Woman. Enter now. Let's find out what this is. Yes, first time I've played it, actually, as you might know.
One more thing. This isn't a ticket for your TV antics. I think for one moment you're creating instant.
Oh, there's some
show.
Very cheesy characters. Series
canceled. Are you, Alice? Anything.
For real. This is a one strike and you're out deal.
Okay, I get it. No dangerous ass clown behavior. I swear.
Oh, hi. You're the new guy. Here, nice driving. You bagged the last slot. That wristband means you made the championship. There are 249 other drivers competing this year, and believe me, every one of them is more famous around here than you.
I crashed that one. It was awesome.
Darius, hi. Hold on a minute, will you? If you want to make a name for yourself at Horizon, it's all about how you drive. The crowds come to see spectacular racing. And I can always use a driver who has the crowd on the side.
That chick Blades wants a piece of me. So I got a wristband. The most common events in Forza Horizon festival events are found all over Colorado and are organized by wristband color. As you graduate to progressively higher wristbands, you'll gain access to new events to try.
Win them, and you'll earn points. Points will get you new wristbands, and ultimately, wristbands will get you a shot at the title.
That's pretty much what I just said, lady.
To see a new champion. So Horizon has given you some cash to get you started. Good luck.
Beautiful graphics again.
Is an off-road event. So you'll need an all-wheel drive car. Let's go to the auto show and buy one.
Okay, sounds like a good idea. We'll go to the auto show, buy a car, give it a paint job, do the off-road race, and then I'll give you a quick look at the multiplayer. Darius Flint is the ultimate Horizon champion. Darius Flint, you'll be going down by my hand and my wheels. Let's have a Subaru. Plates red. 32 credits? Look at that. 32. 32's in every game. It's because developers love Platform 32. Don't know if you guys have noticed. 32's in games? Let me know if you do. They're always there, hiding, waiting. Because all the developers just, they watch Platform 32, they want to put 32's in there to kind of pay tribute to the show. Loading screens. So, here we go, my new car. Here we go, you can use Connect to set a GPS route while you drive. Just say GPS and the Connect menu will appear with more voice commands. Let's try it.
Get your new car at the paint shop, or just head over to the event.
GPS. Next event. Yeah, it worked. Not sure whether you have to speak in the crazy TV voice I use when I read. Let's go find a paint shop quick. GPS!
Turn around.
Reset.
It is safe to do so.
Worked. Okay. Design creator. Let's have a quick look and see. I don't want to spend too long doing this because what have we been? 18 minutes already ish. Paint car. Add decals. Let's add some decals. Each other car consists of several layers, blah blah blah. Lots of layers on the car. New layer, blue. Add a van shape. Ooh, look at this. Let's have that and make it a stupid colour and then put it. Can I put it on the wheel? No. Let's put it there. This car is going to be horrible. Add a decal. Ooh. Who would I like to advertise? Let's advertise. Let's advertise Playground Games. Jesus, that's big. Can I make it smaller? Oh, I could spin it around a bit. I don't seem to be letting me zoom it in and out, though. Let's place it there. Boof. Why can't I move it anywhere? Okay. load a Forza Motorsport 4 vinyl group, I guess. Oh. I pressed a button and it's frozen shit! Come on! Oh, lame. Let's hope this hasn't crashed the game. Lame. Oh, no, here we go. It's done something. Cannot detect any save vinyl groups in Forza Motorsport 4. Okay, that's probably because I didn't do any. Let's add one more vinyl shape. Community vinyls, primitives, gradient shapes, stripes, tears, racing icons, flames, paint splats, cools, loads of stuff. Wow, you can go crazy balls with this. Platform32. Why can't I? Oh, that one. Okay. Oh, you have to do it on the side, do you? Oh, screw it. Right, you get the idea. Oh, shit. Save. Alright. Save to come in car. You get the idea. Loads of liveries and whatnot you can do. You could spend ages tarting up your car. I've just splattered some random shit on the side. Because I can. Okay, let's go. Let's back. Yes, I want to leave the paint shop. Everyone's going to be like, standing on the left-hand side of the car, they're going to be like, oh my god, the car is so beautiful. And then I drive back on the other side and they're going to go, what the hell has that guy done to his car? So we're going to go to the off-road racy thing, do this race, have a quick look at the multiplayer menus, and then sign off. And this let's play first impression. GPS.
Haven't seen you at a festival.
Next event.
In a while. Having too much fun elsewhere.
Nice. Not sure if that would have been any quicker than pressing the button, but I guess I can do it while I'm driving now, so I could go GPS reset. GPS nearest event. Late. It's pretty cool. I like that. There's some parts of Connect I like. Stuff like that. Some parts of Connect I hate, which is a lot of it. Kinect seems to work well for racing games. You can play this game using Kinect. You can play Forza 4 using Kinect. I tried it out. It felt right. I prefer playing games with a joypad, I think. I don't know. But the GPS thing's cool. GPS! I was going to say, wasn't it? GPS! Festival. Paint shop.
Turn around when it is safe to do so.
Chill out, Sigourney Weaver. GPS nearest. No. Nearest. Festival race. Oh god. GPS. Next event. I don't know where I've got to turn off. Fudge. I don't know why I censored myself by saying fudge then. I've sworn about 15 times in this Let's Play already. So yeah, I've never learnt to drive. I did learn, but I never passed my test. Learned when I was like 17. And, ran out of money. The guy said I needed a couple more tests before I was ready for my couple more lessons before I was ready for my test. And ran out of money and then just never bothered again, went off to university and all that stuff and was a poor student and never got around to it in the end. Never really enjoyed it. What do we got here? Okay, let's enter this event. Yep, playing with my weird crappy car. Come on, loading. I'm quite hungry. I'm going to make a pasta bake in a minute. Tuna pasta bake. It's going to be nice, isn't it? So I've won one of 70 festival events. Hello. weird thing with the women in this game. They got lovely bodies, but they all look like they've got car crash faces. Beat Ramon or something. Okay, here we go, babies. They're all pulling away faster than me. I must have had a poo start. So we're up against Barr, Adams, Lamb, and other peeps. It's two laps. My cornering is once more poo-poo. Should follow the green line, really. Got some drift points coming up. You see my combos building. Great drift, great drafting, great drift. Awesome drafting. Drafting. Shit. Not looking. Oh god, no. I need to drive aggressive. Undertake these douchebags. Come on. There we go. Get out of my way. No man's there. The person I have to beat for extra points. Cravash. Stupid name. Kick me in the cravash. Darrow. Oh, Darrow? Break.
Hey, you're starting to get noticed around here.
There we go. First place.
And I might have some more work for you.
Obviously, I'm going to be in first place, though, because I'm just awesome at these games. I don't know why I was surprised that I came in first, though. That I'm in first at the moment. Blake's going to, like, do some kind of crash right at the end. And die. When I'm dying. Come on, here we go. Get around this corner without being a knob. Do it, do it, do it, do it, do it, do it, do it. Yeah, yeah. That's a good game. I'd like to try it out online with more people. I played a couple of street races, point-to-point races, and general like standard circuit races with Larry Bundy Jr. A lot of my viewers will know who he is. I played with him yesterday, but we were literally the only two people online, except for one other guy we were griefing. But there we go, first place, finished first, hurrah! So that's a single-player kind of Forza Horizon Festival. Anyone who's played a kind of open world racing game will be familiar with the style this game's going for, except for it's got all the everything you love about Forza, all the handling, all the cars, all the liveries and everything. It's Forza, but accessible for people like me who are rubbish. But you can still make it feel like a proper Forza game, obviously by turning the difficulties up and stuff. New rival, do I want to race your rival? Not now. Kind of did, but this Let's Play's gone on long enough, and I don't have enough to say about racing games to keep this interesting for a prolonged period of time, I'm afraid. Hopefully, you've been entertained by the lovely visuals and my random rambling. Isn't boring you too much. I could read some more stuff, but it really was putting me off my excellent driving. So here we go, we've opened up a few more events. Interesting, these white highlighted lines are roads I've driven on. If you drive all the roads, you get an achievement. So I could go here and do something, a super sprint, or I could go here and do a festival race. I could go here and check out my car. I could just drive around like a buy treasure map. What's a treasure map? It will reveal the locations of every discount sign in the game. The treasure map will also show you the exact location of a barn find every time one becomes available. I don't know what that is. Oh, I've got no tokens. Would like to wait. Real money? Am I going to have to buy real money? Oh. Got to pay real money to buy tokens to get discounts on in-game items. No thanks. Shut up. Okay. Let's have a quick look at the multiplayer menus, and then I'll let you get on your way. Definitely seems to be a very solid game, though. Something that race fans will enjoy. I like the way it's combining the hardcore-ness of Forza with a more arcadey setting as well. You can find custom games. You can find games. You can create custom games. This is what we were doing last night when I was playing. So you can have private or public. Friends only, invite only. You have circuit race, point-to-point races, street races, infected races, cat-and-mouse races, king races, free roam, and then there is a load of tracks to pick from. They're all for, like, there are different tracks, kind of, for different things. Circuit races. You can choose the time of the day at random, max players, pick what cars you want, how many laps, turn on ghosts or collisions, etc, etc. Loads of options for creating your perfect custom races. You can save the changes. No, I don't want to save it. So you can change your perfect races. You can select cars. You can rent cars from multiplayer from the garage. You can borrow cars from the car club, if you remember the car club. You can use the cars you've got unlocked in the full game. Look at that, you can use the ones that you've decorated like an idiot. Let's see if there's any games online. Beginners. No games online. So, yes, there you go. That was Forza Horizon anyway. You can also take photos and upload them to a Forza-y website-y thing if you so wish. I did one, but I don't know. It's not something I do all the time. Yes, that's Forza Horizon. It's out in the UK and I think worldwide, 23rd of October, which is in a couple of weeks' time. It's got single player, it's got split screen, it's got online multiplayer, and yeah, it's pretty cool. I really enjoyed it, what I've played so far. It looks like the single player will be very accessible for me. Multiplayer, of course, is always fun when you're playing a racing game. This one has got so many different multiplayer options. There's stuff for everyone. So if you like racing games and you love Forza in particularly, definitely pick this one up. It looks like it's going to be getting some pretty damn good reviews. It's got a thumbs up from me for sure. So thank you very much for watching. Make sure you subscribe to Platform 32 for more Let's Plays of games that are not released yet and all that stuff, and there's competitions and live streams and all that stuff. In fact, I'll probably do a community Let's Play kind of live stream thing on this when it's out, so watch this space for a free roamy kind of community live stream on this game once it's released to the general public. Cool, thank you very much for watching, and see you next time. Bye.